All right, Edward Pevos with MLive News, and I am here with Andre Rison of Flint, my hometown, by the way. Flint,
wow,
Southwestern.
I didn't know that. Flint Southwestern.
And you're Northwestern, right?
Yeah, Flint Northwestern. I had a lot of uncles and cousins, and a lot of great friends went to Southwestern, though. A lot of great players come out of Flint Southwestern.
Oh, yeah. And Michigan State, Rose Bowl champ, and Super Bowl champ. I mean, is there anything in your career you haven't done yet? You're a new high school coach, so that's new.
Yeah, high school football, state coaching. You know, champ.
State champs, you haven't done that. All right.
You know, that's on the agenda.
How far did you get at Northwestern? How far did you make it?
As a player?
In terms of the regionals and everything.
As a player, we never made the playoffs. Back in the day, you had to go 9-0.
Oh, okay.
And we used to finish 8-1, 7-2 in a great conference called the Saginaw Valley. And a lot of great teams, a lot of great talent. And unfortunately, we didn't make the playoffs, but we had a lot of pros. We produced a lot of pros, Mark Ingram Sr., myself, and the list goes on. And so I had a great time being able to go back and coach at my alma mater, you know, my first time I had coached years ago. And so I've been coaching now over 14, 15 years. And just landed a new spot at University of Liggett.
Yeah.
University of Liggett, and I'm excited. We got some great returning players, and playing a division now, we stepped up. You know, we went 7-2 our first year, and so you know, they had a lot of success, but it's a tougher schedule, different teams now, you know, different programs. You know, with different programs and better teams comes better coaching. So I'm excited, and excited for the challenge.
Well, you were so much fun to watch. I grew up watching, you know, Barry Sanders, of course. I'm a huge Lions fan, and of course, watching you, Deion Sanders.
Yeah.
You played with Deion Sanders.
Yeah.
Was there anybody better to line up against in practice, to practice against, than him? I mean, for real, like.
I played with some great corners. I played with Charles Woodson, Eric Allen, Dale Carter, James Hasty, Mark McMillan, and the list goes on. And I believe all those guys, even, you know, tried to, like, you know, compare themselves to Deion, you know, the things that he could do on the field. Very gifted, but more studious than what people give him credit for. Everybody thinks you just go out there, put the helmet on, and make plays, but it's way different when you want to keep that level of, you know, success and that level of greatness. You got to work when nobody's watching, and I think he doesn't get the credit that he deserves when he was a student of the game, and that's why I believe that he's a coach now. You know, because of that.
How do you think you would have done? People will probably ask you this all the time, but how do you think you would have done in today's game compared to back then?
Because I thought you was going to say the NBA.
You know, because today you don't have to worry about getting destroyed up the middle by Benny Blades anymore or headhunting. You know what I mean?
Great friend of mine.
But you know what I mean? Like, or Chuck Cecil or something.
Another great friend of mine. both
David
teammates.
Fulcher? Should we go on?
Another great friend of mine. I was great friends with all the guys that were trying to kill me.
I mean, your stats were amazing. Your abilities, your speed, everything was amazing. Would the fear factor be a lot less? Is it a lot less for wide receivers today? I couldn't tell you
because they're playing the game. They're out there. They know the tempo. It's a violent game no matter what. If you played in the 60s, 70s, 80s, 90s, now 2000s, it's still a violent game. Rules have changed, of course. When I played, people didn't have to think about where they were going to tackle you, which body part they were going to attack to get you down on the ground. In today's game, you got to be, you know, thoughtful of that. And not just because of the injury factor, but you'll be ejected from the game.
And that
affects a lot of things. That affects the team in multiple ways. You got a lot of guys that play on defense that play special teams. And so it's just a different game with rules, but it's still the same.
And you're teaching that, and it's evolving and when you're teaching it too. So, yeah.
For sure.
So I play in a – I'm kind of curious. Did you play that old Nintendo game, Tecmo Super Bowl, the 1991 version where you were on the Falcons? I play that competitively, crazy as that is, in tournaments and online. Yeah. Did you play that Nintendo?
We played competitively, but not in tournaments. We didn't have time to go to look up tournaments and, you know, find.
But, I mean, did you play that with your teammates?
Between me and my boys, between my teammates, mostly with my personal guys, you know, that didn't make it to the National Football League, that felt like they could have played. So I left it up to the joysticks. But even after my third, fourth game on video games, I didn't want to lose.
Oh, yeah, competitive.
Yeah, I didn't want
to
lose.
Can't lose.